गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी कम्प्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 1.1 फ्रॉम द चैप्टर इंटीजियर. नाउ हियर वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड विद दिस चैप्टर एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द इंटीजियर्स, द प्रॉपर्टीज विच रिलेटेड टू द इंटीजियर्स. हियर आई हैव लिस्टेड properties of integers and we will be discussing one by one. So the first property is closure property. Before going to learn or study the closure property, here the basic thing it is, we will studying this all of properties for all the four basic operation of mathematics, which are the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. We are going to see on all these four basic operation. For each property we are going to check whether this property is true for plus, minus, into, division. Okay, let's start closure property. Here closure property means, if we perform any operation on two integers, then the result, what the answer which I get, is also integer. If this is the case, then the property is true, otherwise not. For example, now for closure property I need to study addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay. The condition for closure property, when we perform any operation, that is addition, on any two integers, I will take in general A and B. Think this A, B, consider this A, B belongs to what? A integers, belongs to integer, then answer also we have to get in the form of integers only. See students, when I add two integers, the result also what? Here integers, here A, B equals in belongs to what? Here integer. Okay, belongs to what is this, which sign it is? Belongs, first belongs to integer. It's a this notification for integers. Okay, now we perform any operation on two integer, the answer what we have to get? Integer. Take a example, I'll take 5, A has 5 and B has minus 4. First I go with addition operation, that is 5 plus what is B here, I substitute in condition, that is minus 4. 5 plus into minus, minus 4. 5 minus 4, 1. See student, 1 is a integer? Yes, it is belongs to integer. From this we can say the closure property is true for addition of integers. We got result what? Here integers. We can say that closure property is true for addition of a integers. Then I will go with subtraction with the same number. With the same number is, let's see, the condition is A minus B equals to what? Here integer I have to get again. When I subtract any two integer, the result also what? Here integers. See here, with the same numbers I will take 5 minus minus of 4. First remove bracket terms, that is by doing the signs minus into minus plus. 5 plus 4 it is 9. 9 is an integer. Yes, 9 belongs to what here? Integers. So then this also we can say is true for subtraction of integers. We can say the closure property is true for subtraction of integers. Is true for subtraction of integer. Why? Because any two integer we subtracted, we get again what here? Integer. So it is true for subtraction of integers. Next, go with multiplication. The condition it is a into b equals to integer. A into b equals to integer. That is a into b equals to integers. 5, so with the same number I continue. That is 5 into minus 4. Students, while doing multiplication, we not say the greater number. Just multiply the signs and keep the signs with the result. That is plus into minus, minus. Okay, 5 fours are 20. See, when I multiply these two integers, I got what here? Integers. So, minus 20 is belongs to what here? Integers. From this we can say the closure property is true for multiplication of integers. Why it is true? Because the result again we get in the integer form. So it is true, closure property is true for multiplication of two integers. Finally, we have to check for division also. The condition is a divided by is equals to what here? Again we have to get integer only. Now suppose I take 5 divided of minus 4. The answer is 5 by minus 4, or we can write minus 5 by 4. Here the answer in the form of fraction, or we can convert into decimal. But the answer is not belongs to what here? Does not belongs to integer. Does not belongs to integers. This integer addition, subtraction, multiplication belongs to integers. The result is belongs to integers but not division. It means that the closure property is not true. It is not true for integers. It is not true for the division of integers. Is it clear? I will repeat. Closure property that are mainly performed on any operation of two integers, the answer should also be a integer. And it is true for addition, subtraction, multiplication, but not true for division of integers. Got it? Cleared? We will move on next property, that is commutative property. So let us understand what is commutative property. Commutative property deals with order in which addition, subtraction, multiplication and division is done. If change the order, we have to also see whether the result is same or not. For example, if I have two integers, say that is on addition, I will tell any two integers, that is a plus b, it should also equals to b plus a. When I change the order of the two integers, we get equal. If it is equal, we can say it is holds true. If it is not, false. Okay. Then I will make a choice of any two integers. Say A is 3. A is 3. And next B is minus 6. And results also we have to get integers only. A plus B, that is 3 plus minus of 6. Next, minus 6 plus 3. 3 plus into minus, minus 6. Minus 6 plus 3. 3 minus 6, that it is minus 3. And here minus 3. See, we got here, we will see same result. So this LHS part also, RHS part also. According to this, if we change the order, I written A plus A and second I made order change, that is B plus A. If I made a change, the result remain the same. Here result what it is? Minus 3, minus 3. And it is also belongs to what here? Integers. Remains same here. Therefore, we can say commutative property is true for addition on two integers. Addition of two integers. Clear? Now, we have to check for subtraction also. The condition is A minus B equals to B minus A. For subtraction, I'll say same numbers, that is 3 minus of minus 6 equals to minus 6 minus 3. 3 here minus into minus plus 6. 3 plus 6. Next here minus 6 minus 3 minus 9. Here 9, in LHS part we got 9 and RHS part minus 9. Here positive 9, here negative 9. According to this, if we change the order, the result does not remain the same. So we can say commutative property is false for subtraction of two integers. It is false for subtraction of two integers. Commutative property become false subtraction of any two integers, but it is true for addition. It is true for addition. Next, go with multiplication. That is A into B equals to B into A. That is A equals to what here? 3. B equals to minus 6. On multiplication, we have to see now. When order is changed, means B into A. First it was A into B. Next it was order by order changing B into A. It is minus 6 into 3. Here plus into minus, minus. 3, 6 are 18. And here plus into minus, minus. 6, 3 is 18. According to this, if we change the orders of this, the result remains the same. Therefore, we can say commutative property is true for multiplication of two integers. It is true for multiplication of two integers. Now go with division, that is A division, A divided B, and we have to change the order, that is B divided by A. Substitute the values, A is 3 divided and B is minus 6 equals to 3 divided minus 6. B is what here? 6 minus minus 6 and A is 3. Okay. 3 divided minus 6, bracket of minus 6 equals to minus 6 divided 3. This is a question. And see here, 3 divided by minus 6 equals to minus 6 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3, 2s are minus 2. That is, and here 3 ones are 3 minus 2. The answer is, it is 1 is a fraction, that is minus 2. Minus 2, and here is minus 2. Minus 1 by 2 in LHS part and RHS part, minus 2. See here, LHS is not equals to RHS. According to this, if we change the order, that is A divided by equals to B divided by A, the result does not remain the same. It is not equals to each other. So therefore we can say commutative property is false for division of two integers. And subtraction also, it is not equal when we change the order of any two integers. We can say commutative property is holds addition and multiplication. Okay. The next property, it is, that is third property, identity property. Then what is identity property? Identity property, we mean to say that what number, that given number should be performed on mathematical operation in order to maintain identity of that number. Means it should maintain identity of that number only when we perform any mathematical operation. For example, I have a number 12 here. If I write 12, when I ask you, you are going to say 12 only, not 14, 15, is it? Because this number has its identity, it is 12. Now, for addition, how will this number able to maintain its identity? This, what should I add to 12 that does not change its identity? Means it remains 12 only. See, let's see one by one on mathematical operation, that is addition. To remain as a 12, which number is added here? That is 12 plus 0. When I add 0, 12 gives same, means it remains constant. It doesn't change its identity. So here 0 is what here? Addition of additive identity of any number, here 0 is what? Additive identity, because it gives any same number when we add with any number. So 0 is what here? Additive identity. What is 0? 0 is the additive identity of any number. 0 is additive identity of any number. Then subtraction. Here 0 is also called subtraction identity of any number. When I subtract 12 minus 0, again we get 12 only. It gets 12 identity only. So 0 is subtraction identity of any number. Don't subtract 0 minus 12. The thing, it is the identity any given minus 0. So we get 0 has a identity for subtraction. Next it is multiplication. Multiplication, students, here 0 is not a multiplicative identity. Why? Because it does not give a same number. 12 into 0, we get answer as 0. So 0 is not a multiplicative identity. We not get the same number. So which is the multiplicative identity now? To get the same number or a given number, 12 into 1, 100 into 1. See, students, same number, when I multiply with the 1, we get same number. It doesn't change. So 1 is a multiplicative identity. What is 1? 1 is a multiplicative identity. Why 1 is a multiplicative identity? Because when we multiply with 1 with any number, we get the same number. So it is multiplicative identity. Next, division. Division. 1 is a, 0 is not a division identity. Here 1 is a multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity. See, 12 divided by 1, the answer is 12 only. 11 divided by 1, it is 11 only. 12 divided by 1 is 12. 11 divided by 1 is 11. So 1 is a division identity and multiplicative identity. 0 is the addition and subtractive identity. And this is about identity property. Then we move on next property, that is associative property. What is associative property? For that, we need to know meaning of the word association. Here, association means come under a group. Means when I tell 5 students complete work together, here students are associated in a group to complete the work. Is it? Means association means grouping, means together we call as a association. Then, has the property in case of mathematics is about groups. Suppose I have a 3 integers, let the integer A, B, C, means group of 3 numbers, can be associated. Let us see by this three integers. These 2 number, means when I group this, when I group here 2 integers for this side, when these 2 numbers together or these 2 numbers together like this is associated. These 2 numbers in LHS part or this same number in RHS part is hold true. If the result of LHS here, if the result of LHS and RHS are same, we are going to check associative property again on the 4 basic mathematical operation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So one by one we shall see, we shall check all this mathematical operation true for this mathematical operation. Let us take any 3 integer. See, I am taking now A equals to 1, B equals to minus 2, C equals to 3. The condition for associative, that is grouping any 2 numbers with another, that is A plus B plus C. First I grouped A plus B. Next I am grouping B plus C. The condition, we have to get a result LHS and RHS are same. Substitute this value in this condition, that 1 plus minus 2. Next plus 3. Here 1 plus, in the place of B, minus 2 plus 3. 1 plus plus into minus minus 2 plus 3 equals to 1 plus minus 2 plus 3, that is 1. 1 minus 2, it is minus 1 plus 3. Here 1 plus 1, 2. Here 2. 2 equals to 2. LHS equals to RHS. 3 minus 1, it is 2. Here also 2. So we can say, from this we can say, if you change or we group the orders of the given numbers, the result remain constant. We can say associative property is true for addition of any three integers. It is true for any three integers when we grouped differently. Let's say for subtraction, that is a minus b minus c equals to a minus b minus c. This is a condition for subtraction of associative property. A in the place of a, that is 1, in the place of a, minus minus, in the place of b minus 2 minus c, c is 3, equals to a means here again 1 minus minus 2 and minus 3. 1 minus into minus plus 2 minus 3. 1 minus minus into minus plus 3 to 5, greater number it is 3, it is minus 5. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 3, 0. Okay, next here, 1 minus, minus into minus, plus 1 plus 5, that is 6. Here, LHS is not equals to RHS. So, according to this result, we can say associative property is false for addition of any three integers. Next, go for multiplication, that is a into b into c equals to a into b into c. Substitute numbers in the place of a, 1 into minus 2 into 3 equals to 1 into minus 2 into 3. 1 2 is 2, plus into minus minus. Minus into 3. 3 2 is 6. Next, greater number we should not see, that is plus into minus minus. Minus 6. 1 into 2 3 is 6. Plus into minus minus. Minus 6. Here, plus into minus minus. 1 6 is 6. See students, we getting LHS and RHS results same. According to this, we can say associative property is true for multiplication. Is true for multiplication for three integers by grouping differently. Now on division, take that A divided by B divided C equals to A divided B divided C. This B divided C is grouped here in RHS part, and here A divided B is grouped in LHS part. Next, first substitute the values, that is 1 divided of minus 2 divided minus 3 equals to 1 divided minus 2 divided minus 3. Take C as positive, that is 3, and here 3. Next, 1 divided minus 2 can be written as 1 divided by minus 2 divided by 3. And here 1 divided means minus 2 divided by 3. This divided can be written as in fraction form. Now, here 3, here divide is converted into multiplication. To do multiplication, we have to reciprocal the 3 here. That is 1 divided by minus 2. Minus 1 by 2 is same as 1 by minus 2. So into 1 divided by 3. In RHS part here, to convert divide into multiplication, we have to reciprocal this part. That is 1 into 3 divided by minus 3 divided by 2. Now multiple 1 1s are 1, that is minus 1 divided 2 3s are 6. Next equals to minus 1 into 1, it is minus 3 divided by 2. See students, LHS part and RHS part is not equal. By this we can say these are not same. It means division is not true for associative property. Division is not true for on associative property. Is this property clear, children? Now we have to take a last property, that is distributive property. We are going to study the distributive of multiplication over addition and subtraction. Okay, this is slightly different from other property, so pay attention students. In this property we have three numbers, that is A, B, C. We are going to study multiplication of first number distributed over addition of two numbers or over addition subtraction of two numbers. This property we now have to study. See the condition for distributive multiplication over addition or subtraction. First shall we go through with addition, that is A into B plus C. The A number is distributed over addition, that is B plus C, and this can be written as A into B plus A into C. If A is multiplied with two numbers in a bracket, then this can also be written as A into B plus A into C, because A is multiplied over entire bracket and A is distributed over B and C. This is known as distributive property. A is distributed over B and C with the addition. In subtraction means A into B minus C equals to A into B minus A into C. A into B, next plus into minus minus, that is A into C. A into C, let's take a number A equals to 1, B equals to minus 2, C equals to 3. Check in first condition, and this condition take it as a homework. A equals to means substitute in first condition, that is addition. This A is distributed over two numbers on addition. 1 into multiplication over addition. 1 into B is what here? Minus 2 plus 3 equals to 1 into minus 2 plus 1 into 3. Okay, 1 into plus into minus minus, 3 minus 2, 1. 1 1's are 1. Plus into minus minus, 1 2's are 2. In RHS part, 1 into 3 it is 3. 2 plus 3 it is 5. Sorry, here minus 2. Plus 3 plus it is 1. See students, here LHS part equals to RHS part. By this we can say distributive property holds true multiplication over addition. Multiplication over addition. I hope you all understood properties which I discussed today. Thank you.